Hi everyone, welcome back to another video. In this video, I will show you how to install Moodle on your iPhone. So here I have my iPhone screen, and this is my Moodle installation. First, there are some prerequisites that we need to set up in order for us to actually use or to actually install the Moodle mobile app on our iPhone. Alright, so first let's go to site administration. Once open, go to advanced features and then scroll down to where you see enable web services. Make sure that this box is checked. Scroll down to where you see enable web services for mobile devices. Make sure that this box is checked. Click on save changes. Then go to server, scroll down to where you see web services and make sure you click on manage protocols. Make sure that your REST protocol is enabled. The eye should be open and not closed. Okay, you can save this. Once that is done, go to general and make sure that your Moodle mobile app appears on your general tab. Okay, so there's my Moodle mobile app, and now I can go and install my mobile app on my iPhone. So first, let's go to the App Store. So it's this one here. I'll click on that. It will open this. I'll then type in my search bar or just click on my search bar there, and it will open this. Type in Moodle. At the top here, type in Moodle, and then click on go. Okay, so you can type in Moodle and then just click on search. Okay, it will search for the Moodle installation. This will show up here. You can then click on the download button there. It will download Moodle. Then once it's downloaded, you can click on open. And then it will open Moodle to connect to your Moodle site. You can allow notifications. If you don't want to allow notifications, just click on don't allow. But if you want to allow, click on allow. Then where it says your site, just click in the area there and then type in your site's name. Okay, so my site's name is https. /, and then it's teach.elearningportal.co.za. Okay, so once you see your URL there, the full URL, just click on connect to my site. It will then start connecting to your site, and if you provided the correct URL, it will automatically connect. Then you need to provide your username. So my username is Andy, and then I need to provide a password. So my password for my Moodle site, I'll type in my password. And then once I've typed in my password, I can click on login. So it will then log me in. Okay, it will provide me with some messaging. So I'll just click on okay, got it. And there's my Moodle site set up on my iPhone. You'll see there's my site's name. I can scroll down to where my content is. There's a Wednesday, 26th of February. There's my test assignment that is due. I can go to my profile and see what's happening in my profile. I can go to my grades. I can go to my files. I can go to reports. I can see which badges I've received. I can go to blog entries. I can go to everything here. If I want to close this, I just click on close. There's my Moodle Basic to Intermediate. There's my course. I haven't had any progress yet on this course. So, and then I can also see my timeline here. I can also see my calendar events, and I can click on my calendar events and it will open. It will show me that there's a calendar event for the 26th. I can click on that. It will show me that there's an assignment due for the 26th. I can then go back and go back another step, or I can go back altogether to my calendar and then go back to my course. I can scroll up and scroll down. If I want to access my course, I just click on my course name there and it will take me to my particular course. I can click on got it. So there's my course set up here. I can then access my resources from here. I can access my grades from here, and I can even go further. Next to my grades is competencies. I can go back to the particular course. I can see the announcements. I can see everything in my course. I can go to the three dots here at the bottom and it will show me what announcements there are, everything here, and all the courses I'm enrolled in. So that's that. Or I can just, if I'm done with this, I can close this by clicking on close, and it will take me back to my course. And this is how easy it is to set up your Moodle app on your iPhone. So make sure you as an administrator, you set up all the prerequisites, going into site administration and then going to appearance, and making sure that you go to not appearance, general, and then advanced features, and then making sure that my web services are enabled. Make sure that your enable web services for mobile devices. You can click on save then and go to your server and make sure that manage protocols, your REST API is enabled. So those three should be enabled for your mobile app to work and to install on your mobile device. If you want to log out here, you can go to your profile within this setup here. So scroll up to where you see your profile name there. You can click on that name, and then at the bottom you can log out. If you want to close this, you can just close it. If you want to go back to your home screen, you just scroll up and you'll see that there's the icon of your Moodle installation. And you'll see there's a one. The one means that there's a notification. Remember, we've enabled notification. So the mobile app is sending you notification from the platform. So let's click on that again. And you'll see here at the bottom, there's a bell icon. Click on that and you'll see the notification there. It says there, if I open this notification by clicking on it, it will show you that, dear handicap, you are successfully been enrolled to the course test. And now you can view. So, and there's the message. You can answer the message, or you can see the details there. So there's my details, and I can go back. I can go back. And I can go back one step. Okay, so there's the message again. If I want to see all my courses, I'll click on this education cap and it will show me all my courses listed here that I'm enrolled in. If I want to start messaging, I'll click on this icon here and then I can start messaging those that are in my contact list. So currently I'm Andy. If I open this now, you'll see that I can start typing a message. If I want to see who's in my contact list, I click on contact list and you'll see there's no one yet in my contact list. But I can search for someone in my contact list. If I have people in my contact list, I can go back. And then once I'm here, I can go to my control panel there at the bottom. And this will take me back to my dashboard. When I'm done on my mobile app, I just click on my name. I then click on log out, and this will log me out. If I need to log back in, all I need to do is click on my URL, or I can click on my name. It will then ask me for the password. I can type my password in there, and then I can click login. So as long as you have the Moodle mobile app on your iPhone, you as the user will have access to this, and you can only add your password and you'll be logged in to the site automatically. If you found this content useful, please like it and subscribe to my channel, and also share it with your friends and family.